نعم. So, اختلاف موجود. So, you know, we know that اختلاف is present. And we don't say that we can have this اختلاف for comfort in the deen. As أهل البدع وأهواء وأهل الزيق. This is comfort in the religion. It's okay if he has his opinion and I have my opinion. We are not like the Yahud. We're not like the Yahudi, Ya Abdullah. This is Ahl Sunnah. تحسبه جميعا وقلوبهم شتى. That you think they are تحسبه جميعا وقلوبهم شتى. You think they are all united, but their hearts differ. We're not like the Yahud. That's the way of Ahl al-Bid'ah. They want to make this picture. All our hearts are united, but our hearts differ. This one believes that Allah is everywhere. This one believes they can dance in a circle, saying, who, Allah, Allah, Allah. This one believes that we can make ta'an on the ulama. We can speak ill of the ulama to the end of the... This is not from the minhaj of Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. So Sheikh Saleh Fawzan, he mentioned, لِأَنَّ الدِّينَ لَيْسَ فِي أَقْوَالِ عُلَمَاءِ. We're going to clarify this, inshallah. That the deen is not the statements of the ulama. As some believe, the Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah have driven to the side of being like the Sufis. Like the Sufis who, whatever their sheikh say, سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. They hear and obey. Whatever they sheikh say, they hear and obey. Blindly following. That's what they claim what Ahlul Sunnah does nowadays. Blindly follow. لِأَنَّ الدِّينَ لَيْسَ بِأَقْوَالِ الْعُلَمَاءِ وَإِنَّمَا الدِّينَ بِالدَّلِيلِ. The deen is just not the statements of the scholars, but the deen is proofs and evidences. Meaning that those ulama, Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, whom we love, is from the aqad of Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, and the minhaj of Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, is that we respect the ulama. We do not make ta'an on the ulama. We do not speak ill of the ulama of Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. We love them. But everyone has a place. No one's above the haq. Not even a scholar. No one's above the truth. Yani the deen of Islam is dalil, proofs and evidences. That scholar has to be in agreement, his statements has to be in agreement with the kitab and the sunnah. He has to be in compliance with the book of Allah in the sunnah of Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or we reject his statements. This is Ahl al-Sunnah. فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِ. If you differ in anything, then take it back to Allah and his messenger. هذا هو ميزان. This is the scale that we judge by. إخوة بارك الله فيكم. This is what we judge by. Not the رأي of فلان. The opinions of so and so and so and so. But our affair is that we return to the ميزان. That ميزان, that scale, is that it has to be judged by the book of Allah Azza wa Jal and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Has to be judged by the book of Allah Azza wa Jal and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the person from Ahlul Ilm, and he's able to distinguish, and he knows yani from the, which is called Rajih, which is the strongest of the views, and he takes it. Huh? He takes, he's able to distinguish. But as for the Awam al-Nas, the Mubtadi'een, not the mubtadi'een. There's a difference between the mubtadi'een and mubtadi'een. Yani the beginning student. The awam. All of us from the awam. For the awam, that is upon him to ask the people of knowledge. As Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says in the Quran, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلُ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask the people of knowledge when you don't know. Refer our affairs, أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ. Those who are grounded, راسخون في العلم. Those who are deep rooted in العلم. In our day and time, just to mention a couple of them, a few of them, from the heads of them, although people don't like to hear this, but we don't care. Haqq is haqq. From the heads of them, the Allama, the Muhaddith, the Imam of Jahwa Ta'adil, Rabi' ibn Hadi al-Madkhari, Sheikh Rabi' ibn Hadi al-Madkhari, Hafidhullah Ta'ala, wa Sheikhana Sheikh Ubay ibn Abdullah al-Jabri, Sheikh Abdullah al-Bukhari, Sheikh Hassan bin Abdul Wahhab al-Banna, the likes of the A'imma, of Ahl al-Sunnati wal-Jama'ah, refer our matters to them and other than them from the A'imma of Ahl al-Sunnati wal-Jama'ah. We're going to make it clear, because we all have all these shubahats that go around, that our ulama is not restricted to them, as some believe and some say. Our ulama is not restricted to them. But we love these ulama, all of our scholars of Islam. But we refer our affairs to Ahlul Ilm. We refer our affairs to Ahlul Ilm. And we upon the methodology of that great Imam, Imam Dar al-Hijra, Imam Malik, rahmatullahi alayhi wa rahmatul wasi'a, where he mentioned, "Kulluna uradun wa marududun alayhi illa sahib al-hadhi al-qabr." Everyone's statement is accepted and rejected. Everyone's statement is accepted and rejected. And he pointed to the grave of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, except for the one that's in that grave. Meaning when we hear the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the affair is over. Khalas. The affair is over. We want to hear about your opinion, what you think, how you feel. The affair is over. When we hear Qala Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has said, the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has spoken, khalas. We take that affair, because when you reject the Sunnah, you reject the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you're rejecting what? You're rejecting the paradise. This is the tariq, the paradise, our way to paradise, by Nabiyyina Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Min aqwalihi wa af'alihi, from his statements and his actions, from his approvals and his disapprovals, and things that he abandoned, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that's of his sunnah. And the likes of that great Imam and other than him have made this statement. That great Imam, Imam al-Shafi'i, rahmatullahi alayhi wa rahmatul wasi'i, he mentioned, إِذَا صَحَ الْحَدِيثِ فَهُوَ مَذْهَبِي. When there's an authentic hadith, then that is our madhab. That is our way. If we're not calling this great Imam, Imam al-Shafi'i, he's not calling to blind following. And Abu Hanifa, rahmatullahi alayhi wa rahmatul wasi'i, they're not called to blind following. And the great Imam, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, and Imam Malik, they're not called to blind following. And these great Imams, how much more of the Imam of our day and time? We don't blind follow. We're with the Dalil, that makhraj from fitan, that way out from the trials and tribulation to safeguard ourselves. Referring back to the Kitab and the Sunnah ala fahm salaf ummah. Na'am. The great Imam, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, he mentioned, he said, عَجِبْتُ لِقَوْمٍ عَرِفُ إِسْنَادُ وَصَحَّتُهُ وَيَذْهَبُ إِلَى رَأِي سُفْيَانُ. He said, I'm amazed at a people. This is what this great Imam, Imam Ahmad, the Imam of Ahl al-Sunnati wal-Jama'ah, that he mentioned. He said, I'm amazed at a people who know the isnad, who knows the chains of narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَيَذْهَبُونَ إِلَىٰ رَأِدُ Sufyan, and they go to the opinion of Sufyan, Sufyan al-Thawri. And this is not making ta'an of Sufyan al-Thawri, but this is putting him in his place, that no one's above the haqq, no one's above the narrations of the salaf, no one's above the narration that leads back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No one's above the haqq, no matter who he is or where he is. And he's a greater ummah. Sufyan al-Thawri is a great Imam, the Imam of Ahl al-Sunnati wal-Jama'ah. Imam Ahmad, who's from the great Imam of Ahl al-Sunnati wal-Jama'ah, he said, عَجِبْتُ لِقَوْمٍ عَارِفُ الْإِسْنَادِ. I am amazed, astonished of a people who know the isnad, who know the chain of narrations and its authenticity, and they go to the ra'i of Sufyan. So how much more an individual with ikhwa akhawat? How much more that's not qualified? That's not even on the level of Sufyan al-Thawri. Not even on the level of Ahmed ibn Hanbal. And you reject the narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to go to his narration, to go to his statement, to go to his opinion. La ilaha illallah. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he mentions in the Quran, فَيَحْذِرَ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةٌ أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَلِيمٌ. فَيَحْذِرَ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِ. And he warned those is in opposition to my command that they will be afflicted by some fitna, or afflicted by a painful chastisement. Do we not know what the fitna here is? Mufassirin, they explain that the fitna here is shirk. The fitna here is shirk. Warn those individuals that's in opposition to my command, yani it's khilaf, they will face some fitin, some trials and tribulation. The Ahlul Bid'ah wa Ahwam, Ahlul Zayg, in opposition to Kitab and the Sunnah, they will be faced with trials and tribulations. فلا بد قول أحد مع قول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم فواجب علينا عند اختلاف أن نرجع إلى الميزان. فلا قول أحد. So not statement, no statement from any individual with the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So it's obligatory upon us during the time of differing to return to that ميزان. We return to that ميزان. We return to the scale of the Kitab and the Sunnah. وَهَذَا مِنْ رَحْمَةٍ. This is from mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what's upon us, ayyuhal ikhwa akhawat. It's returning to the Kitab and the Sunnah. And by way of that, referring back to the ulama of Ahl al-Sunnati wal Jama'a fi asrina, in our day and time. So this is what I wanted to present tonight, inshallah wa ta'ala. And I just wanted to say to the brothers here that it makes me feel good to know that the brothers are inviting other tulab al-ilm, students of knowledge that are and was beloved and loved by the ulama of Ahl al-Sunnati wal Jama'a. Loved by the ulama of Ahl al-Sunnati wal Jama'a. And this is by way of sticking to the scholars. We have people with their ignorant statements. They say, we're not going to take from the tulab. We're not taking from the students of knowledge. We're only going to take from the ulama. Kadhab, kadhib. You are lying in your statement. When you're saying that you're not going to take from the students of knowledge, but we're only going to take from the ulama of Ahl al-Sunnati wal Jama'ah. You're lying in your statement. Because those same scholars that you say that you're only going to take from refers you and commands you to take from the tulab al-ilm. The likes who have benefited from Sheikhana Sheikh Muqbil al-Hadi al-Wadi'i rahmatullahi rahmatul wasi'ah, our brother and our elder in knowledge, Abu Hassan Malik, Allah yahfadhu, and Hassan Sumali, and Anwar Wright, the likes of these individuals, and other than them. But it makes me feel good that you're inviting some of them down, wallah alhamdu minna, to come and benefit the community. And in my advice to the brothers here, for each one of you, that when they come in 2 weeks, when our brother Abu Hassan Malik and Anwar Wright comes in 2 weeks, that each one of you come and benefit from them. And benefit from them. And spread to your friends. And spread to your friends and your colleagues to come here and benefit from them. Benefit from them who has sat at the knees of Sheikh Muqbil and sat at the knees of Ubay ibn Abdullah and Jabari.